out of this world, man.
What was that?
I don't know. Sometimes this space stuff is just so over my head that I don't know what to say, so I just say out of this world. And
okay,
hope
well, we don't have to talk about
with
it.
My pun.
We can just talk about the weather down here, not in Mars. We won't make you forecast that.
Yeah, thankfully nobody ever has asked that. All right, well, yeah, things are shaping up to be a little more active as we get into the weekend, or the, I should say later part of the work week and into the weekend and early next week. So overall, I mean, kind of moral of the story here, yes, mm-hmm. things are changing. We don't know exactly how all these storms are going to impact us, specifically as far as rain amounts, snow totals, any of that. But we do know that this pattern is changing, and this is overall just a good thing to see, especially for the ski areas and our mountains. They need all of that precip they can get. So here's what's coming. We do have kind of a slew of things on the way. Today, we are going to see a brief period of rain. I think it's looking more and more likely. It's not going to be something that's going to continue all day, but a light drizzle is possible at times. Hit or miss showers won't count them out of the question either. Our next storm, this one looks to be more impressive. When you see that there's a almost 100% chance of rain at some point on Thursday, that shows you, yeah, this storm system looks to be a little bit wetter. We could see some decent rainfall out of this one. This, I think, will carry over from Thursday afternoon into the evening into Friday. So the timing on that one slowing down just a touch. Here's our third storm setting up. And again, this one's further out, so we don't want to start talking details or anything, but we do know that there is a good shot of some precip coming in, and the air is going to be colder and cold enough that we may see some snowflakes or possibly even snow on the valley floor. Models still kind of in disagreement as far as where those snow levels will land. Those are the kind of details that we'll nail down for you here in the next few days. So here's that first storm. Again, you can see it already kind of crossing into central Oregon. It loses a lot of strength as it carries over into southern Idaho, so we're not expecting much out of today's. This is the one that I'm thinking is going to be a little more impressive, and you can kind of see the detail. You saw how well defined that curlicue was with the area of low pressure. That's kind of an indicator of a good storm system coming through. So this one will lift in from the southwest, should drive some snow into the mountains. Snow levels will start out quite high, but they will eventually drop. And then there's our third storm. This one comes in further from the north. So there's a good indicator that it's going to drive colder air in with it, ushering it in from the Gulf of Alaska. But I just like to see this parade of storms setting up, barreling through the Pacific Northwest. That's what we want. That's what our mountains need at this point in the season. So a more active pattern shaping up for us over the next week, if not longer. Here's the storm that we're talking about this morning. Again, you can kind of see the bulk of this is up in parts of north and central Oregon and into south central Washington. Light showers, though, starting to pop up in parts of Malheur and Harney County. So those are what we're going to be keeping an eye on to see if they'll cross over the border, get over some of these mountains and into the Treasure Valley. I think there is that potential as early as maybe mid-late morning. If we see something before that, should just be relatively hit or miss. But overall, the storm losing a little strength as it pushes over the Oregon border. So here it comes. You can see those darker green colors signifying some moderate rainfall. It loses a little bit of strength as it moves in to our state, but I do still think light rain is a possibility today. Not a lot as far as amounts, and even in the mountains as far as snow showers, I don't think we're going to accumulate much, if at all, or anything before this thing zips out and packs its bags, moves on pretty quickly, continues to kind of weaken as it passes over off to the east of us. Leaves us behind with possibly clearing skies as early as this evening, so your commute home should definitely be dry. It'd be more mid-morning to about the lunch hour that I'd be concerned about today as far as a few showers or wanting that rain jacket with you. Thursday's storm. This timing has slowed down a tiny bit, so I'm going to say we'll make it through most of the day on a dry note, but by that evening commute, there comes the rain moving in from the west, and then we'll watch for the snow showers to start in the highest peaks of the mountains. Snow levels going to start out pretty high. They will eventually drop, so I think we have the potential to see some good snow out of this storm in our mountains, but here's what I'm talking about. 6,500 feet to 8,000 feet. That's where the snow levels will be when this storm kicks off Thursday afternoon. By Friday afternoon, they drop quite a bit down to the point where, yes, the foothills could see some snow, whereas the rest of us will be talking about rain, but we're going to start out only with high elevation snow. More accumulation will pile up, especially for those ski areas, as the snow levels start to drop. So it'll be a transition with a cold front coming through, but when the air gets colder, that's when I'm thinking we can squeeze some good snow out of it. Today's high about 43 this afternoon with a brief window of rain. Probably that best chance going to be late morning through early afternoon, but know that, hey, we might see a hit or miss shower through the day today, but nothing to write home about. Dry, but a little breezy tomorrow. Also going to be breezy today, especially between Mountain Home and Jerome. Otherwise, we're watching Thursday into Friday. If we see any snow showers Friday, I just want to take note, kind of mention it. I don't think it's going to be enough to accumulate. If so, very little, and it'll be warm enough that we melt it off that afternoon. More snow is possible, or at least that chance of it getting into Sunday and Monday of next week.
All right. Lots going on.
Lots going on.
You'll keep track of it. Thank you, Denny.